Hello, friends, you're the Lonesome Gamer. And I'm still playing Hornet Leader, Carrier Air Operations. And it's now actually day 6 of my 7-day campaign, the Taiwan Defense 2008. And until now I'm doing really good. I had a very good day 5. I was really lucky there. I was able to destroy that government building here. And actually, I did an overkill, which gave me one additional victory point. And then there was a fleet supply that gave me 4 special option points. So now I have actually... Then I could afford the R&R option, so my pilots could recover from stress even more. And now I have 13... SO points remaining. So, and if I add now up what I got to these 10 here and 18. So now I got 18 victory points, and to get a great result, I would need actually 28. That's definitely hard. So, well, I could try it, I mean, but it's tough. I mean, if I attack this carrier fleet here, that would give me 5 victory points. Problem is, I need 8 planes to do that, and it gives me a +2, +2 stress. So if I will do this mission, I'll do it at the very end, I guess. Not right now, but... as my last mission, so the additional stress is not my problem anymore. Okay, so now let's draw some target cards. We're allowed to draw 5 target cards. Okay, so this is... Well, that's a rail line. That's interesting, that's a secondary target. We can use up to 4 planes, and it would give us 2 hit points, 2 victory points. The good thing is it's a stress -1. It's a small target. I have to check out what that means, but in general this could be interesting actually. That's 16, so let's see where we got that. It's here. In this row here with a stress 2. So this is not too bad. Could be an idea to use that or to fly this as a secondary target. Let's draw the next card here. Okay, this is the SAW fleet, and that's 4 planes, 2 victory points, vehicle improvement, increase the weight point penalty of all targets by 1. So that doesn't really matter because we already have so many, such a big weight point penalty. It's now actually 3, so we have to use this... this refuel option anyway. Okay, that was my third target, or my second card actually. Now it's the third one, and that's a major airfield. Well, that's a tough one. 7 pilots. Improvement, all targets get +2 center bandit draws. Okay, so from now on, that's something we have to take under consideration. Oh man, this is tough. And I draw another card, so this is now card number 4. SAM trap. That might be actually interesting. So that's also a secondary target. Stress plus 2, fixed objective, 2 SA 8As, 1 SA 6 and 2 SA 13s. I guess I will fly this too. I might fly these two targets. Together they give me 5. I think that could be an interesting idea. Problem is, this gives me plus 2 stress. That's a problem, actually. Yeah, that's definitely bad. Okay, I think I will draw my last target card. Missile boat fleet. So again, the weight point penalty of all targets is increased. This time I think I will really attack this one, the missile boat fleet. I think I'll try that one. So I throw that away. Place that here. And what I do is, I will attack the missile boat fleet and then the rail line. Okay, so we are allowed to take 5. Well, actually, we have to attack the missile boat fleet because of this scramble thing. So always, if you draw a scramble card, you have to stop drawing and you have to attack the fleet. Okay, anyway, so it's small. Let's see what that means. Okay, let's subtract 1 from all air-to-ground die rolls against the target. Then we have dispersed. Each air-to-ground counter cannot inflict more than 1 hit on the target. Okay. And it's a vehicle. Some weapons get a bonus attack to attack vehicle targets. Okay, so we'll see about that. Okay, so first let's place the sights. Okay, so this is definitely going to be an interesting mission. Normally we can take up to 5 planes to fly this mission. Point is, we have now 13 SO points remaining. If we take now 5 planes and we have to use the refuel option, then there would only be 8 special option points remaining. And because we have to use this refuel option in every mission that we're going to fly during this campaign, because of all these fleets here, which would add weight point penalty, we would simply not have enough special option points to use this refuel option to fly missions that give us enough points. We need 10 points to do a great result. I mean, good is now not a big deal anymore. We only need 1 point to do a good result. But 10 points to do a great result. And so the idea is now, if we fly only with 3 instead with 5 planes, then we only have to pay 3 of these special option points, which might be an advantage. And it might sound pretty crazy, but actually I think it is possible to fly this mission with 3 planes. First, let me see, we got Talon, he's got 1 stress, and he's our flight leader. And then we got Lightning, and he comes with 2 stress, actually. And then there is Mustang, with zero stress. Okay, so the basic idea is now to, yeah, I guess we approach the target here from the left side somehow. And, well, there can be, let's see, there can be four bandits in the approach areas, three in the center, that would be seven, plus two additional bandits because of the major airfield is eight, minus one bandit here because of this intel is, wait a minute, no, it's two, it's nine, so minus one is eight again. So there could be a maximum of eight bandits. I don't think there will be eight bandits. So this is kind of a gambling, but I think I have pretty good odds here. So what I do is I only take six of these AIM-120 independent weapons with me. And this guy has a plus two modifier. And he might take some extra stress, maybe. It's possible. And then I think he has a real good chance to destroy all bandits on the map. He's got that situational awareness, which would give him the first shot. So I think that could be okay. Next point are these two sites here. We have down here the SA-11 and up here an SA-10. And they both have a range of three, so they could attack us in the first turn. And basically we don't have any fast pilot with us. So what we got to do is we have to use his situational awareness and I probably use, yeah, that's not sure. Maybe I use even two of these AGM to destroy one of these sites. It's got an air to ground plus two, which is really good. And then I can use his situational awareness in combination with his flight leader ability and give the situational awareness to Mustang, and he then can try to destroy the other site. Okay, so then we are here and there should be no attack. If there are strong bandits left, we have a problem, we might have to abort the mission. But okay, I mean, then it doesn't matter. We have this good evaluation, pretty sure. So, but let's assume it goes all according to the plan. We then can approach, and then we're gonna try to destroy this thing here, that side, and this side here. The SA-88, and the ZU-23-4. And, to do this, we would then have 1, 4 AGM-88 left. So that should work out, I guess. And then we should be able to enter this area here without any danger. And we need to do 4 hits to the missile boat fleet. So my idea is now we use rockets. Only rockets, because it's a small target, that means, oh no, wait a minute, it's a dispersed target, and that means we cannot do more than one damage per counter. So it doesn't make sense to use big bombs or something like that. So I'll use rockets, and I got ten of these rockets, and we got a modifier of plus two air to ground here, and this one also has a modifier of plus two air to ground. So, but then we have a modifier of minus one because it's a small target. So in the end we need to roll a six for a hit. So with 10 rockets, we need to roll a six to hit. I think we should be able to destroy about six hits, so we should be able to deal about six hits, I guess. And we only need four. So if we're approaching this in a theoretical way, we should be successful. But there are a lot of things that can go wrong. And this starts actually with the draw target, with the draw target bound event card. So let's see what we have here now. Well, that's Charlie Foxtrot. Reduce the number of turns you can spend over target by one. That's not so bad after all. But we got to remember that. Gives me one additional experience point. Okay. But that should be okay. I mean, that's... Yeah, that's fine, I guess. So, and then... We have to place our aircraft. Okay, so we enter from up here. And now we see about the bandits. And this is going to be the interesting part. So we only have one bandits in each approach area. Let's see. That's a good start. No bandit. Okay, that one is okay. He has a plus one modifier. All these things are really important now. Because we'll only get one shot per bandit. Probably. No bandit. Very good. And no bandit. So in the end, I think we can already say this is going fine. And now we have three bandits in the center. And that is also a good one. It's a plus two modifier. And no bandit. And no bandit. Okay, we were amazingly lucky here. That was just great. Who dares wins, I would say. And then we have to draw two additional bandits because of this major airfield here. And they go to the center. So that's a bad one. The MiG-29 here. And another one, no bandit. Okay, fine. And then we can remove one bandit. Actually, it doesn't even say it has to be a center bandit, so I guess it can be any bandit. But I will remove the MiG-29, of course. Okay, so that was definitely a good start. Oops. Okay, fantastic. Am I right? Or did I remove now one? I don't think so, actually. Just two bandits? That's all? That's amazing. Okay. So now the first thing we really have to take care of are these sites here. They're dangerous. So Talon will use his situational awareness, which allows him to shoot. And he uses now two. Oh, wait a minute. Wait a second. I forgot the over target card. Yeah, draw over target event card. Okay, so let's see what that is. Bad Chow. Well, that doesn't look. Add one side to a random area containing your aircraft. Okay. Well, that's not good. So let's see what that is. Let's hope we're lucky here. Okay, I am lucky. This is just infantry. They won't attack. I'm not cheating here. I'm not making this up. This is just a lot of luck. I have to admit that. This is just amazing. Okay. So now they cannot hit us because they only can fire at low altitude. So now we start this whole attack. And we first use our first, these two AGM-88. Talon does so. And he will shoot at the SA-11 down here. So he's got a plus two modifier, so he needs a two to hit. Okay, he's got two rolls to do that. Yeah, Okay, so that wasn't a problem. This thing is destroyed. And then Talon will spend another situational awareness for Mustang. So he's now also allowed to shoot, and he now also uses two of these AGM-88 to shoot at the SA-10 up here. And he also has an air-to-ground modifier plus 2, so he also needs a 2 to hit. Yes, no problems here. Okay. And now it's Lightning will actually use his situational awareness to shoot these two bandits. And just in case we come into a stupid attack by an event card or so, he only uses two rockets per bandit. Well, just give me a break here. Lightning has a plus 2 modifier, so actually for the MiG-21 he doesn't have to roll because it comes with a plus 2 modifier, so one AIM-120 is enough to destroy the MiG-21. And then he uses two rockets to destroy the other MiG, and he needs a 2 to be successful here. Yes. Okay, fine. Okay. Yeah, that was, well, that was actually all according to the plan. We were amazingly lucky with the bandits, but yeah, that's just great. And then we will move our airplane, and they go here now. And now it's actually the second turn. Okay, so now what we're gonna do is we simply attack. Well, first of all, yeah, that's first the fast pilots can attack, but there is no fast pilot left. Then the bandits could attack, the sights and bandits could attack, but they're all not within range, and there are of course no bandits on the board anymore. So now the slow pilots can attack, and now this guy will actually use his AGM-88 to destroy this site here. It's got a plus 2 modifier, so all it needs is a 2 to hit. And that is a hit. So that site is destroyed. And then it's let me see here. Yeah, okay. I'd say it's Mustang then. And T-Rolls uses this AGM-88 to destroy that side. And he also needs a 2 to hit here. Ah, that was a miss. Okay. Well, that's not so bad. We still got him, Lightning. And he can now use two of these AGM-88 to shoot at this site. And, well, he needs a 4 to hit. And that is a hit. Okay. So now that side is also destroyed. Okay. Well, we're doing really good. And now we can fly here into the west approach zone. And we go now to low altitude. Oops. And we come to turn 3 now. Okay, same thing again. No attacks. And now we have to destroy the missile boat fleet. And okay, well, actually, I think, well, we got another turn left, so yeah, it's hard to say. Okay, what I'll do is I will take an extra stress point here. Talon will take an extra stress point and shoot basically all of his rockets. Why not? Let's hope we don't draw one of these stupid cards for our way back, but I think that that should be fine. So, okay, so this extra stress point is actually taken away by the small modifier. Well, basically not the stress point, but the positive modifier that we would get due to taking the stress point. This is right away taken away because the target is small. So we only have a plus two modifier, and we now can shoot all these rockets. So we need a 5 to hit. And, well, let's hope for the best here. First shot. That's a hit. Awesome. Second shot. Miss. Third shot. A hit. Fourth shot. That's another hit. It's looking good. If we do one more hit, mission is accomplished. Nope, that's a miss. But okay, we were doing really fine until now, so we have 3 hits already. And then it's Mustang. And, well, not sure. Shall I take an extra stress point? Well, I don't think so, actually. What I'll do is, well, there is still some time left. So I'll shoot 3 rockets here. I keep 2 in case I don't hit. Then I can still take another hit point and try my best with the last 2. But for now, so I need to roll a... I also have an air-to-ground modifier +2. I need to roll a 6 to be successful here. And I got 3 chances to do that. That's a miss. That is now the second one. And that's a hit. Fantastic. So I destroyed the missile boat fleet. Well, that's awesome. Okay, great. What a success. I did this mission with 3 pilots. That's just amazing. And now I draw my homebound event card. So that's a target of opportunity. When you draw target cards for the next day, treat any available target as having the secondary notation. Well, that's a good one. That could actually really allow me to... gain quite some victory points in the last turn, in the last day. Yeah. So we have to remember that. Okay. So that's... that's then the end of the mission, and we're flying home, and well, we were just doing great, and now we have to do our paperwork. Okay, so actually we were pretty successful. We only get 1 stress here, because the target is right here. That means that the pilots with the coolness of 1, they will not accumulate any extra stress. Because of the distance of the target, only the stress they took during flying this mission because of the of the stress due bombardment or something like that. So TALEN is now at 2 stress. And Lightning is at 3 stress because he doesn't have any coolness value. And Mustang has 0 stress. And they all gained 3 experience points because of Charlie Foxtrot. And, well, yeah, so that's basically it. And I'm thinking about attacking the rail line during this day, actually, and probably also, or pretty sure, not with 4 planes. I'm also trying to, but I'm not absolutely positive about that. I have to think this over. So anyway, hope to see you on my next mission. Until then, bye.